Hello everyone, let's start with question number 1 of exercise 4.2. So in this it says state whether the following quadratic equations have two distinct real roots. Ab yahan pe baat ho rahi hai two distinct real roots ki. Iska matlab kya hua? Ki iske paas aisi two values nikalni chahiye jo alag alag. Maan lo ki 4 or 3, it could be anything. To ye condition kab lagti hai hamari? Jab hamara discriminant is greater than 0 ho. तो d की वैल्यू क्या होती है? b square minus 4ac is greater than 0. तो अगर ये कंडीशन सैटिस्फाई होती है, तो then you can say it has two distinct real roots. Let's try for the first one. So d equals b square. B in this case is minus 3 square minus 4ac. A is 1, c is 4. So minus 3 square is 9. 9 minus 16 is minus 7. इसका मतलब जो हमारा d है is lesser than 0, क्योंकि देखो minus 7 है, minus 7 is lesser than 0, so therefore it has no real roots. Let's try for the second one. For second one, d equals b square. B in this case is 1, 1 square minus 4a. A in this case is 2, C in this case is minus 1. So we get 1 minus 4 into 2 is 8, 8 into minus 1 is minus 8. So it will be plus 8 here, so 9. So now you can see that D is greater than 0. And if D is greater than 0, that means it has two distinct real roots. Now let's try for the third part. Third part is 2x square minus 6x plus 9 over 2 equals 0. So d in this case will be b square minus 6 square minus 4ac. A is 2, c is 9 by 2. So 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. We are left with 36 minus 36. So we get the value as 0. तो इससे हमें ये समझ आ जाता, जब भी हमारा d 0 के इक्वल होता है, तो इससे समझ आता है कि इक्वेशन के पास टू रियल एंड इक्वल रूट्स है. नाउ वी विल ट्राई फॉर द फोर्थ पार्ट. सो अगेन वी नीड टू फाइंड d इन दिस केस. सो इट विल बी b स्क्वायर. b इज माइनस 4 स्क्वायर माइनस 4ac. 3, c is 1. So minus 4 square is 16. 16 minus 4 into 3 is 12. So 16 minus 12 is 4. So in this case, d is greater than 0. And if it is greater than 0, then it means that it has two distinct real roots. Now let's try for the fifth part. That is x plus 4 whole square minus 8x equals 0. So we need to simplify this equation and we get x square plus b square 16 plus 2 into x into 4 minus 8x as it is. So you get x square plus 16 minus 8, sorry, plus 8x minus 8x. So 8x and 8x gets cancelled out here. We are left with x square plus 16 equals 0. So now d is b square. B is missing here, so it will be 0 square minus 4ac. A is 1, c is 16. So it will be minus 64, which is less than 0. But less than 0 is ka matlab no real roots. Now let's move on to the sixth part. Again in this case, we have to solve the equation. So it will be x square minus 2ab x under root 2 plus under root 2 whole square minus 2x minus 2 equals 0. So you are left with x square minus 2 under root 2x plus 2 under root and square gets cancelled out minus 2x minus 2. Now 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. Now we get the equation as x square minus 2 under root 2x minus 2x equals 0. Now from the last two terms we can take x common. So it will be x square minus x common. You are left with 2 under root 2 plus 2 equals 0. Now we need to find the d out of it. So it will be b square minus 4ac. So in this case, my b is the number which is attached to x. So it is 2 under root 2 plus 2 whole square minus 4ac. A is 1, c is 0. There is no value for c. So the second term is 0 itself, because any number multiplied times with 0 will give us 0. Now we need to solve this part, the first part. And minus ahead of it, because here we have minus sign, so therefore we need to write minus ahead of it. So the number itself, you can see, will be greater than 0. If we have minus 2 under root 2 plus 2 whole square, and minus means minus minus, so it will be only a positive term. So therefore d is greater than 0, and d has real and unequal roots. It doesn't have any distinct roots in it. Now let's do seventh part of it. D equals b square. B is minus 3 under root 2 square minus 4ac. A is under root 2. C is 1 over under root 2. Under root 2 and under root 2 gets cancelled out. You are left with 9 over 2 minus 4. So now you get 9 minus 8 over 2 by taking LCM. So you have to multiply the second term with 2. So you get half. That means my d is again greater than 0. So it has real and distinct roots. Next is 8th part. 8th part is x into 1 minus x minus 2. So you need to solve this first. So x with 1 will x. X with x is x square minus 2 equals 0. Now we need to rearrange this equation in terms of quadratic form. So it will be minus x square ahead, then x, then minus 2 equals 0. Now we need to find the value of d. B square minus 4 is. So b is 1 square minus 4a. A is minus 1. C is minus 2. So it is 1 minus 8. It will be minus 7, which is less than 0. That means it has no real roots. Now let's try for the ninth part. Ninth part is, again we need to solve, or we need to expand the terms. So x with x, it will be x square. X with 2, so it will be 2x. 1 with x, minus x. 1 with 2, it will be minus 2 equals 0. Sorry, I missed plus 2 here as well. So plus 2. So minus 2 and plus 2 gets cancelled out. You are left with x square minus plus x equal 0. Now we need to find d out of it. So d will be b square. B is 1 in this case. The number attached with x. So it is 1 minus 4ac. A in this case is 1. But c in this case is 0. There is no numerical term here. So 1, d is equal 1, and 1 is greater than 0. That means it has two distinct real roots. Now the last part, question number 10. Part 10 says x plus 1, x minus 2 plus x 0 equals 0. So we need to simplify this. X with x, so it will be x square. X with 2, it will be minus 2x. 1 with x plus x, then 1 with minus 2, it will be minus 2, then plus x as it is. So we can't cut anything here out of it, but you will see in the next step that we can actually, so minus 2x as it is, x plus x plus 2x. So now we can cut down minus 2x and plus 2x. We are left with x square minus 2 equals 0. अब b की तो कोई value नहीं है यहाँ पे, so let's find d. b is 0, 0 square minus 4ac, 1, c is minus 2. So 4 into 2 is 8, minus minus is plus, plus 8. So d is greater than 0. अगर 0 से बड़ा है, that means it has two distinct real roots. So that's the end for question number 1 of exercise 4.2.